One vital component of the True North Logic Professional Learning Portal is the course proposal feature, which allows our users the ability to submit courses for approval so that they can be released in our course catalog. This brief tutorial will show you how to properly submit a course for approval, mark attendance, and also properly close out of the class so that the attendees receive the PD credit they deserve for attending. Before we begin, it is important to note that only instructor-led courses may be submitted for approval. If a specific employer or department is interested in creating a self-paced online training course, they must reach out to the Multimedia Professional Development Department for assistance. You can contact us by calling any of the three numbers seen on the screen here or by emailing profdev@tusd1.org. To get started on proposing a new instructor-led course, first log into the Professional Learning Portal. Click the Propose a Course Quick Link, which can be found on the Quick Links tab at the top bar of the homepage. On the next screen, click the Propose Course button on the right side of the screen and select New Instructor-Led Course. Once your Create Instructor-Led Course page pops up, fill out the following information fields. Fill out course title, making sure to put the current school year somewhere in the title field. Course description, which can be a brief summary of what specifically this course will train attendees on. The disclaimer, which only needs to be filled out if there are any special details about the course. For example, some courses are specific to a certain job title, or maybe the second course in a series that requires the attendee to have taken the first course prior to enrolling. For the next few drop-down selections, make sure the following are selected. For course provider, it needs to remain on district sponsored. Office can be changed to suit the department which is offering the course. If you are unsure, leave it set to curriculum. Intended audience can be modified depending on which classification of employees the course will be targeting. The three choices are administrator, certified, classified, or also some combination of those three. Professional development models can also be changed to best suit the nature of the course. If you are unsure, set it to course. The following course hours section must be filled out as well. Check the box to the left, and then enter in the total amount of hours for the course in the Hours Information field. For example, if a Wednesday PD course meets 36 times over the course of one school year for 1 hour each, you would enter in 36.0 into this field. The rest of the selections on this page may be skipped, except for the course survey at the very bottom. All other courses, such as operations certifications, CPR training, and other technical courses, may skip adding a course survey entirely. When you are finished, select the Create Instructor-Led Course button. Congratulations! Your course has been created and a number will be assigned to the course. However, there's still a few more steps before we submit the course for approval. We still need to make a section or multiple sections depending on the type of course you want to submit. In order to do this, scroll down to the bottom of the page and click the New Section button in the bottom corner. Sections will give logistical details of your course so attendees will know where and when to attend. For your section title, enter in a title that will help you remember which section of your course this is. For example, a course with multiple sections covering the same training on different dates may simply have a title with the date attached, such as CPR training for January 1st, 2020. A course with multiple sections that cover different topics may have completely different titles for each section. And finally, a course with only one section can have a section title similar to the course title itself. The credit hours number should already be filled out, but feel free to adjust it in order to reflect the total length of class times in the section. The attendance dropdown can be adjusted to reflect whether your course will be held over one period or multiple periods covering a full day. Next, skip down to the training location and enter the course address and specific room in the corresponding fields so that your attendees will know where the course will be held. It is important to note that you must have this information verified before you create a course. We will not accept courses without training locations or training locations that are subject to change. The contact field is your opportunity to provide contact information for the course attendees, should they have any questions about the course before it occurs. The maximum number of participants field is the capacity of your course, which is usually dictated by space restrictions of the training location. Waitlists may also be added if you desire, in the event that an employee enrolls but ultimately withdraws before the course occurs. In that scenario, someone on the waitlist would be automatically added as an enrollee. The start date and end date are the days the course begins and ends. If it is one course held on one day, make sure you select the same date for both of those fields. The end of registration date is the last day employees are allowed to enroll in the course, and the waitlist cutoff date is the last date employees may add themselves to the waitlist if you choose to have a waitlist attached to your course. The start time and end time are the specific times that the course will begin and end. It is important to note that you can add multiple start and end times after you create your section, in case your course has multiple sessions per day, or is held over multiple days, such as in Wednesday PD courses. After you have selected a start and end time, skip the rest of the options and click the Create button at the bottom of the page. Your section has been created, but you still need to add instructors and class times. You can do that by scrolling to the bottom of the next page and clicking the Instructors and Class Times buttons. The Instructors button takes you to a search page where you can search for instructors by entering in their first and last name, then clicking the Find User button. Once they pop up, click the box to the left of their name, and then click the Add User button. You can add as many instructors as you need, but it is also important to keep in mind that instructors will have access to manage the roster and other details of the course, so choose appropriately. You also will need to add yourself as an instructor. Once you have added all the instructors you wish, click the Done button to return to the section page. The Class Times button will allow you to add specific class times for your section. This feature is important for Wednesday PD courses where multiple class times with the same start and end time are required for the section. To add a new time, click the Add a New Class Time button and a default time will appear with the selections you made prior to creating your section. Both the date and time can be modified, and multiple class times can be added by simply clicking on the Add a New Class Time button repeatedly. It is important to keep in mind that your class time dates should be within the period you chose for your course, and the total hours from the multiple class times should equal the course hours you have already outlined when you created the course. When you are finished, click Save and Exit. The hard part is over. Scroll to the bottom of your section and click the Done button to head to your course projects page. On the course projects page, find your created course and click the drop-down arrow on the left side and select Edit Course. This will take you to the Manage Course section, where you will need to create four brief categories before you can submit your course for review. The first category is Course Availability, where you can manage enrollment access for your course to employees at specific sites. It is important to note that this category does not reflect where the course will be held, rather which employees at which sites will be eligible to enroll. First, click the Create button to the right of the title. On the next page, if you click Add before changing anything, you will choose the default selection of District for Select Type and Tucson for District. This will make the course available district-wide for every employee previously outlined in the Intended Audience section of the course creation page. If you want to limit enrollment access to a specific school site, change Select Type to School and a third option will appear, allowing you to choose the appropriate selected site. Once you have selected your desired site or sites, click Add for each site and then Done at the bottom when you are finished. Back on the Manage Course page, click the Create button next to Syllabus to access four fields where you can answer prompts to give a more thorough description of what the course aims to accomplish for reporting purposes. Here you can also copy and paste a syllabus which has already been created for your course. If your syllabus is a PDF, you can add it as a file attachment to your section or to the course itself. When you have completed all four fields, click Save at the bottom to return to the Manage Course page. Next, click the Create button right of Strategic Goals. Here you are given a list of the 6 TUSD strategic goals of our Unitary Status Plan. Copy and paste the goal or goals that your course aims to satisfy and click the Save button at the bottom to return to the Manage Course page. The last category is Standards Alignment. Click the Create button next to Standards Alignment and scroll through the list to find the professional or content-focused standards your course aims to satisfy. You can expand a category by clicking the small box next to each title, and then you can select multiple subcategories by clicking the box next to each pertinent subcategory. When you are finished, click the Save button on the bottom of the page. You're ready to submit! Click the Submit for Review button on the Manage Course page, and your course will be sent to our office for approval. Once approved, you can access your course roster through the Administration Quick link at the top of the home page. From there, click the Course Administration link, and then click the List All button at the bottom of the page. Scroll through the list to find your course and click on the title to enter the course itself. On the Manage Instructor-Led Course page, scroll to the bottom under Sections and click the drop-down arrow to the left of the desired section, then select View Roster. The next page, titled Section Roster, is your home base for roster management. Once you scroll down, you should see a collection of buttons followed by the actual roster list of employees who are registered for the course. Feel free to navigate these buttons to see which may be of use to you while you manage your course. At any time, you can add an employee by clicking the Add Learner button and searching either their name or employee ID. You can also remove employees from the roster by clicking the Remove Participants button and then clicking the box next to the employees you wish to remove and finally clicking the Delete button at the bottom of the page. It is important to note that manually adding an employee to or removing an employee from a roster will prompt an automated email to that employee from the Professional Learning Portal. And however, it is crucial that you have previously contacted that employee and explained why they are either being added or removed to avoid any confusion on the employee's part. In order to mark attendance, wait until after your course is complete and you have your sign-in sheets handy. On the Section Roster page, click the Attendance button. On that attendance page, there will be a grid of your roster and your class times where you can go through and manually mark attendance for your section. If your course has multiple class times, such as a Wednesday PD course, we recommend that you keep up on attendance throughout the year so this task isn't overwhelming come May. After you complete your attendance and you are ready to close out your course, return to the section roster page and click the attendance hourly percentage credit button. Then click the update button on that page to assign the hours attended to each employee enrolled in the course. This is a fairly straightforward process for a course with one section and one class time. However, it is a vital component of your long courses, such as Wednesday PDs, where the employees receive the appropriate credit for sessions they attended. Once all the credit has been assigned, the last button you click on the section roster is Roster Status. This button will allow you to change the registration status of each employee in your course from registered to completed. That will complete the course for the employees, pending completion of their survey, if applicable, and give them credit for attending the course. It will also effectively close out your course, finalizing your course management process. That's it! As always, if you have any further questions regarding course creation and management in the Professional Learning Portal, feel free to give us a call at 225-5572, 225-5571, or 225-5570, and we can help you out. You can also email us at profdev@tosd1.org.